Hi again. Welcome to not my kitchen this time. Welcome to my living room. Yeah, I know we've upgraded. It's been a while since I've gotten on camera or I've uploaded any video in a recent amount of time. Well, it's been a few days, so you know, not that much of a time gap compared to what I, you know, usually do. But yeah, welcome back. A lot of things have happened since I've been gone. First off, I graduated high school. Yay, let's clap it up for that. Yeah, man. Yeah, high school's over with. I'm done with that chapter of my life. Graduated. Proud of it. This is obviously a huge achievement for me. I feel like it hasn't fully set in yet that I'm actually gone from that school. You know, I'm finally done. Yeah, man. That's I'm just speechless. I'm actually out of there, and I actually accomplished something that huge. And yeah, man, it's a great achievement. I also brought a tripod, as you can clearly tell, because I'm not holding the camera up by, like, you know, little weird piece of furniture that I usually would have in my kitchen. But yeah, no, I bought a tripod. It's a 74 inch one, I believe, where it films. You can like hold it up all the way up to like the ceiling almost, so we can get more like dynamic sort of shots. This is also for the upcoming fan films that we are going to be producing on this channel. Yeah, I have not forgot about that. This upcoming summer, man, get ready. It's coming, dude, it's coming. But that's not what we're here to talk about today. Today, we're here to talk about the brand new Jurassic World series that just came out. The direct sequel, not a spiritual successor. I don't know why people keep calling this series a spiritual successor, even though it's like literally a direct sequel to Camp Cretaceous. Jurassic World Chaos Theory, season one anyway, season two has not came out yet. Now, I've been keeping track with this series relatively ever since it was announced back in, right? Because we haven't gotten that many announcements or really that many marketing for Chaos Theory at all, really. We had that announcement teaser back in, I think it was 2023. Then we had like a small little teaser trailer sometime then we had a full-blown like 1 minute, I think 1 minute or 2 minute trailer. Then the series just came out, so we had like three pieces of teaser media for it, or teaser pieces of content for it, and that was it, really. So if not a lot of people know the series exists, I'm not surprised, because they haven't advertised it very well, which, you know, knowing I'm a Godzilla fan, so yeah, I can relate to that. But yeah, no, this series was, I actually enjoyed it. I really did enjoy the series. Nevertheless, I've been keeping track of it. I saw it and I enjoyed it, which I've just said previously. I was most intrigued by the plot points of this series. I feel like that's what really gripped me. The fact that, okay, so essentially the basic plot is that the Nublar Six, that's what they're called, right? After Camp Cretaceous, our main protagonist from Camp Cretaceous, they have survived the events of Jurassic World and are now living their own lives, but they're being hunted down by somebody. They're being hunted down by somebody. Why? We don't know how. They're being hunted down by various means, dinosaurs, actual people, or accidents, like, you know, a simple car wreck, or, you know, maybe an assassination sort of thing, that sort of stuff. And the main selling point of the series is Brooklyn is dead. Dead, essentially. But when we go further down the line, talking about the series, we'll find out why I put in air quotes dead. But yeah, the plot is the Nublar Six are being hunted down by some organization, because there's always an organization in the Jurassic Park series, or a secret organization controlling something behind the shadows. It was Engine, then there was Biosyn, then now Manticore, and whatever this is now. But yeah, no, I was very intrigued by the plot. The plot is very good. It's very gripping. It's very, I like it when this is gonna sound weird, but I like it during time skips. It's not all like, or during, after epilogues, it's not all just like, you know, oh, sunshine and rainbows. I like it when some stuff goes wrong, you know, not a lot of stuff, but like some stuff goes wrong, because it feels more realistic. It feels more gripping. It gives us something to, like, you know, watch for and, you know, be entertained by. I'm not opposed to just completely everything going A-OK epilogues, because, you know, sometimes it is very warranted. You know, the battle has been long fought and hard and it's over, so let's just relax. I do like those sort of epilogues, but then again, I can't help but be attached to these, like, you know, everything's good, or is it, you know, sort of things. I do enjoy those sort of epilogues, and Chaos Theory definitely provides us that, you know. It shows how the kids are, or, well, teenagers now, well, semi kind of adults. They're college age, right? They're either post, they're post high school to college age kids. So I guess I can call them adults. How the adults now are handling their trauma, the situation that they were put into, and how they're, you know, adapting to living back in the normality again. Well, the closest thing to normal again, because this does take place 6 years after Jurassic World. So I think we're way past Fallen Kingdom, and, you know, the Lockwood Estate has been, you know, taken care of. The dinosaurs have fully escaped, and they even make references to it too. I think Darius makes a reference to the Lockwood Estate and all that. And yeah, so all the dinosaurs are released into the wild, into the, you know, modern world. And yeah, so this is the normal now. And it shows how they're, you know, adapting to it and how society is adapting to it. And I like that. I like that a lot. They're expanding the universe of the Jurassic World series, which, you know, is basically expanded universe. Chaos Theory. It is basically like the Star Wars expanded universe of Jurassic Park. And yeah, plot, fantastic. Loved it all. Great stuff. I do love the plot. Now, I really want to talk about the characters. That's something I really want to get into. And of course, who better yet to start off when talking about characters other than the main character himself? Darius Bowman, the D-Man, Dino Nerd. Yes, he is back and he is still the main character of the series. I hate his hairstyle. I tried to like it, but I just cannot keep on. I can't keep on seeing these black characters with the Killmonger hairstyle. Please die off soon. Please, we need to kill it off. Miles had it. Eddie Gordo from Tekken has it. Please, just no more. We've had enough of it. No more. Give him a dreads, afro, I don't know, something. Just anything other than that Killmonger cut. Anyway, appearances aside, I do like his character design other than that hairstyle. The character designs. The character designs are fantastic, by the way. I like every character design in the series. They're unique in their own way. It shows how well they've aged up. The animation and CGI is way better too, but we're gonna get into that later. Darius, I do like what they do with Darius. They do something pretty interesting with him in episode one. It doesn't continue on for very long, but, you know, for the time it lasts, it is very interesting. In episode one, so essentially, so the plot is Brooklyn is killed by a rogue Allosaurus, and in episode one, Darius's whole thing is like he's hunting down that Allosaurus, right? He's, you know, isolated himself from all the rest of the New Guard Six, from everyone, really. He's staying in like a little log cabin that's, you know, fenced off from everything, that has like all these, soup can warnings. Warning signs. He's just isolated away from everybody. Bells in case he wants to know if anybody comes through or comes near his house. He's just completely isolated, and he's one mind track focused on that Allosaurus. And there's an interesting line. The Allosaurus, by the way, has a fantastic design too. The Allosaurus is really cool. But there's an interesting line that he says within episode one, and I think it's to Ben, I believe it is, when Ben first comes in at the end of the episode. He says that Allosaurus is nothing but a mindless killer. And it shows just how much he's devolved, really, from this, you know, the kid who understands that dinosaurs are animals and you can't hold them to the same moral standards that you do as humans. But now, because he's struck with grief, he's just like, hey, that's a mindless killer. It's just a destructive monster and it needs to be taken care of. So I did like that sort of nice little touch of characterization of, you know, seeing how Darius has devolved into this, you know, one-track mindset of, I have to take care of this Allosaurus for Brooklyn. You know, I'm not just doing it because of my trauma. I'm doing it for her. It's what he's telling himself. But yeah, it's just a great character moment. It doesn't last for very long because he is more focused on saving everybody else and trying to find out why they're being hunted and all that. But Darius's character throughout Chaos Theory is pretty good. I do like his characterization. He still has, you know, that grief moment. He still has, you know, his little speeches and all that. But a very interesting development that happened is that it's revealed, I think it's in episode 5, I believe it is. It's revealed that Darius was actually in love with Brooklyn. Like, not like sibling or friendship love, like romantic love. Like, he liked her. That's a sort of stupid thing. Yeah, he loved her, man. He loved her. And I don't know if they did this because of the... I don't know if there was, like, some backlash, or they received some backlash from Kenji and Brooklyn being together in Camp Cretaceous, but I kind of like it. I kind of like Darius X Brooklyn more than I do Kenji X Brooklyn. I don't care about ships before anybody gets in my comment section trying to say, oh, well, we got a classic Darius X Brooklyn shipper here. I don't care about ships. They're the last thing I want to care. Last thing I am interested in when I'm watching a dinosaur show. So, but I will say it would have made much more sense if Darius and Brooklyn liked each other in Sasara Drop Something. It would have made much more sense if Darius and Brooklyn liked each other in Camp Cretaceous than Kenji and Brooklyn. Kenji and Brooklyn seemed more like just friends. I feel like they should just stay friends, you know? But, you know, I guess the creators felt differently, and we got Kenji X Brooklyn in season 4 and season 5. I feel like because Darius and Brooklyn had much more time together, you know, they related to each other more. They had somewhat similar struggles, you know, and in season, not even in season 3 or season 2, season 1, 2, all throughout the seasons, they just felt like they had much more chemistry, much more moments together. Just, it would have made much more sense if Darius and Brooklyn were together, but, you know, it's not what happened. But it seems that they're going into the Darius X Brooklyn direction for this series specifically, because there is going to be a season 2. Season 1 just sets it up perfectly for a season 2. There's no way there's not going to be a season 2 unless, I don't know, the ratings are bad and it doesn't get viewed a lot. Watch this series. It's very good. I want season 2 greenlit. But yeah, Darius is fantastic. I love Darius. He's a great character. I like he's kind of like the same as he is from Camp Cretaceous, but in a good way though. It's not like, you know, it feels like we're having a rehashed character. No, Darius is still like, you know, the same lovable kid, dino nerd still, but you can feel that he's matured a bit. He's definitely matured. He's very grounded, he's very logical, you know, logical thinking. At first, he doesn't believe that they're being hunted, unlike Ben. We'll get into Ben in a little. But yeah, Darius is just all around fantastic. I love Darius. A S-tier character in this show. Ben is good, you know, he's not bad, but he just feels like his season 1 Camp Cretaceous self. I don't know, I just get the same vibes that I got from season 1 Camp Cretaceous Ben to Chaos Theory Ben, you know what I mean? Like he's a lot paranoid like he was in season 1. You know, he's definitely grown up, he's definitely bigger. Dude's like a goddamn football player. Dude has a massive growth spurt, but yeah, he's still the same timid, not timid, more, you know, out there kid, you know, wild thinking, just jumping to the most outlandish conclusions. You know, Ben fully believes that they're being hunted. I don't think he even needs that much evidence on it. He's on Dark Jurassic, by the way. Stupid ass name. Dark Jurassic sucks ass. You literally just call it the Dark Web. Just call it the Dark Web. We all know what it is. There's no need to say like all these weird in-universe Dark Jurassic things. We're good on that. I'm pretty sure, that existed before, right? Wasn't it Dominion? I don't think so. That's probably so stupid I forgot. As long with a lot of things in Dominion that were pretty stupid and I forgot. But yeah, Dark Jurassic, stupid ass name. Ben, however, is, you know, active on that site. He's, you know, again, paranoid like he usually is. But Ben's pretty cool. I do like Ben. Ben's good in this series. There's not a lot to talk about with him. He's just the same character he kind of was in Camp Cretaceous. Again, not a bad thing. It feels like we're just returning to form. You know what I mean? With a lot of these characters. Yasmina isn't really the same. Sammy's not really. I'll get into them in a second. Definitely Kenji, though. I want to talk about Kenji. Yeah, Ben's just kind of the same. He's cool. I do like Ben. He is a good character, but, you know, not much really to talk about. He's just, you know, the same as he always is. Sammy, my girl Sammy, my favorite lesbian. Sammy's cool. I do like Sammy. She's much more emotional as she is in the series. She's much more emotional in this series than she was in Camp Cretaceous because there's a lot more. I feel like she's a lot more pressured. She's trying to distract herself a lot from Brooklyn's death. She's trying to just find out things to do. She took up baking. She's had her family's little farm ranch. She's holding Bumpy. Bumpy's back in the series. Yay! Our girl Bumpy. She's holding her safe there. She's not with, she is with Yaz. I got so scared the fact that they broke up. I was so scared that they almost broke up for a second, dude. You got me, Chaos Theory. You got me, but no, they're still together. It's just that Yaz and Yuna is like, we'll get into Yaz, but just know that she's not currently living with Sammy. But Sammy is, you know, still trying to keep in contact with her because she doesn't want her. She's just scared that, you know, Yaz and Yuna doesn't like her anymore. She still wants to stay in contact with each other, you know. But Yaz has her own things going on, and that's a conflict that's, you know, comes up in the episode where Yaz and Mina appears. But again, Sammy is really good. I do like Sammy. She's much more emotional. She's going through a lot more, you know. Yaz isn't with her. Brooklyn is dead. What is about to say dead? Died. Brooklyn died. It's just a lot of pressure for her, you know. She's trying to, and now she's being hunted. You know, that's another thing to be added on her, you know, little stuff to worry about our girl. But yeah, Sammy's a great character. I love Sammy so much. She's definitely grown on me from Camp Cretaceous. I wasn't there that big of a fan of her in previous series, but the sequel series, yeah, she's fantastic. I love her to death. I love her little hair dye too. Was it confirmed that she did that because of Brooklyn's death, or is it like just her style now? I don't know. I like her hair dye. If she did because of Brooklyn's death, that's so fucking sad. But if she did it because Brooklyn helped her with it or something like that, that's also fucking adorable and cute, and I love it. And yeah, Sammy's fantastic. I don't know how many times I can say it, but I'm gonna say it as many times as I can. Sammy's a fantastic character. Love her in this series. She also knows karate too, or what does she call it? Whatever. It's karate. Basically, essentially karate. So she kicks some ass too. Yeah, she definitely has some fight moments. I like that she gets her little things to do, little quirky tidbit things to do. And yeah, just all around great character. Then next, of course, we have Yasmina. And like Sammy, Yasmina is done perfectly in Chaos Theory. I love Yasmina in this series. She essentially, after Camp Cretaceous, she essentially is in a therapy group where far off, away from everybody else, where essentially is it an island? I think they specify if it's an, I don't think, remember if they specify if it's an island or not. I'll edit it and blow up it's an island. But she's like in a far off area that's completely isolated from dinosaurs. Completely isolated from dinosaurs, as it gets invaded pretty easily by a rat? It's like a Spinosaurus sort of genus type. I don't know the correct name. Dang, I used to be so on my dinosaur game, man. I used to know all types of dinosaurs and all that. Where did the times go? But hey, yeah. So Yasmina's basically there to, you know, obviously deal with her trauma, you know, of what happened with Camp Cretaceous, because that was a major plot line in, I believe, season 4 for her, and dealing with that sort of stuff. And yeah, she's, you know, living, she's healing from it, she's growing from it, away from Sammy. She doesn't want Sammy to believe that she's weak and needs help protecting herself and all that. She wants to do this because she genuinely believes that because she's strong enough to handle it on her own. She wants to prove to Sammy that she's strong enough, that she doesn't need coddling, she doesn't need to be comforted all the time. And she definitely proves that in the episodes after her arrival. She saves the group from drowning, she calms Sammy down, they get back together, it's super sweet. They're probably my favorite couple in the whole series. And yeah, Yasmina, like Sammy, is fantastic. I love my girl, I'm glad she's back. Her design is fantastic too. Now up for the man, the boy, the muscle man himself, Kenji probably has the most tonal and personality change out of the whole group. I don't think he makes like a single joke that's reminiscent of Camp Cretaceous, of what he would do in Camp Cretaceous. So after Camp Cretaceous, it's revealed that he and Brooklyn broke up because Kenji, very uncharacteristically, as we've seen from his previous character trait from Camp Cretaceous, he's enjoying nature. You know, he's enjoying life. His dad got arrested. He's living with the Bowmans. I assumed he moved out. You know, he's now just, you know, living life. He's grateful for everything. He's enjoying the dinosaurs. There's like a little like Paralophosaurus down there that like glow. They're like bioluminescence is the word I'm looking for. And every time the sun sets, they like glow next to the waterfall. And Brooklyn misses it, and that's when Kenji's like, all right, look, I can't keep doing this. You're clearly not interested, and you know, the love just isn't there. So I think it's time we broke up. So yeah, they're broken up, and after Brooklyn's death, he obviously feels very sad about that. He feels, you know, very guilty, just like Darius. Oh yeah, Darius feels guilty because Brooklyn had called him, and he was supposed to be there, but he wasn't because he had confessed to Brooklyn. Okay, so after Kenji and her broke up, it's a whole thing. After her and Kenji broke up, she went to Darius's place, and they chilled and stayed for a while, and that's when Darius fell in love with her. Not during the events of Camp Cretaceous, it was after, when she was staying at his house, and he doesn't know how it happened, it just happened. So yeah, Darius fell in love with her, and he confessed to her, but she didn't feel the same way. And because of that, Darius didn't want to go see her because he was too embarrassed when confronting her, which, you know, is a reasonable reaction. It's reasonable to do something like that. You know, I'm not going to blame him for it. He didn't know that she was being attacked by a dinosaur, and, you know, the message that, or attacked by an allosaurus and all of that, almost dying. And the message she was going to send him, communicating to him that she was being attacked by said allosaurus, didn't send. So yeah, he had no clue. He was basically, you know, oblivious to the fact that she was dying. But yeah, nah, Darius obviously still feels guilty about that, because of course Darius will feel guilty about that. And Kenji also feels guilty about that too, because that was still his ex. He still loved her, you know, he still cared for her deeply, even if they were broken up, and you know, there's still some love there for her. And yeah, Kenji is just completely serious, man. He's you know, plays it straight as it is. I think Kenji and Brooklyn are the only characters who got their voice actor chance, because it's very noticeable. Kenji's voice actor is the same voice actor for Taigen in Blue Eyes Samurai, and he does a fantastic job, by the way. The voice acting is A1, like S tier all around. It's great to have the original cast back, but Kenji and Brooklyn's new voice actors, they do great with the material they're given. They're fantastic stand-ins, and yeah, nah, you can just feel that's the raw emotion in Kenji's voice anytime he speaks. Like, you just tell he's been withered, he's damaged, he's broken, he's sad. He runs a rock climbing group too, essentially. That's like the running gag for him anyway. And he's just a very damaged and broken person after Brooklyn died. And he's even more damaged. There's like a great breakdown scene where like Kenji's like crying down on the side of the road after basically visiting his father from prison, or not from prison, from a halfway house. And he gets attacked by Atrociraptors there. And we're gonna get into that in a second, but oh man, I have a character I want to talk about. She's pretty cool. And he gets killed by Atrociraptors, and you know, there's just this fantastic scene where he's breaking down, crying, just you can just feel the raw emotion, man. And it's wonderful, it's a wonderful thing. Kenji's new voice actor, he's probably my favorite voice actor from season one. He does fantastic with what he's given, and it's just fantastic. And so him and Darius aren't really tight right now. They're just, you know, he blames Darius for Brooklyn's death, as, you know, he would, because we need conflict in this story. And they get past it. He tells Darius tells Kenji about, you know, I did love Brooklyn, and it wasn't when you guys were together, it was after you broke up. And you know, they work their issues out, you know, they settle their differences aside, and they're like, okay, we gotta do this for her. Let's put our differences aside. You're my brother. Let's do this, man. And it's just fantastic. It's still crazy to believe that he and Kenji were essentially brothers. Yeah, they lived together for all those years after Camp Cretaceous. Darius' mom took him in and all that. And it's like, oh, man, beautiful stuff, beautiful stuff. But, Kenji's fantastic. I love Kenji in this series. I love him more than I did in Camp Cretaceous. He definitely has a lot more stuff to do. A lot more, you know, characterization, a lot more stuff that I can empathize with. It's all great stuff. Brooklyn is not dead. That's a big spoiler, everybody. Brooklyn's not dead. Wow, how could we possibly have known that? Like, come on, we all knew Brooklyn was dead. She's alive. She only got her arm bitten off. She was apparently doing some shady work, trying to, like, piece something together, because there's this big conspiracy going on that she's trying to cover up, that she's trying to uncover and all that stuff. We don't know anything about it. I'm just giving you the pinpoint details of what they tell us. It's gonna possibly be more revealed in season two. Brooklyn's alive. Her hair is shorter now than it was before. She only shows up in like small flashbacks in between the series, but she makes a full appearance in the last episode. She has like one arm, her hair is like super short, and yeah, no, she looks fantastic. I can't wait to see more for her in season two. Now, for the side characters, this is one side character that I absolutely adore. She's probably my favorite character in the series, like no lie. She's definitely, Sammy and Yasmin are great, but this character, oh man, she is, woo! She is something else, man. She's like our darker version of Owen Grady, if that makes any sense. She's like has this whistle, or like she controls Atrociraptors and then like do her bidding, but it's not like a parasitic sort of relationship. No, it's actually, she cares for them very deeply. She does care for him, like Owen does. You know, she has a lot of care for him. She's not going to put him in harm's way when there are other options to get the job done. You know, she's not a heartless monster, but, you know, she is intimidating as hell. She's super pale, too, has, like, freckles all over her face. She wears, like, military sort of outfit. Sounds like a bobs, and, like, you see her big forehead, too. I can talk to her because, hello, big forehead, but, you know. She's just an all-around cool character, man. I love her. She's so cool. I love the fact that they introduced a character like this. I hope we get to see more of her in season two. She is awesome. I love her, man. Side characters were cool. There weren't that many of them. There was a guy that drives them around a lot, and he essentially drove the Allosaurus to Brooklyn so she can get killed, and he was paid off to do it, but he wasn't aware that he was being paid off to do it, so he feels guilty about that, and he decides to help Darius and Kenji, you know, solve her death and all that. Well, not solve her death, but, like, drive him around places. He shows up in the last episode, too, and he's, whatever, I don't really care that much for him. There's a fake reveal of the Mega Boss. There's, like, a guy who, like, runs the DPW, the Dinosaur Protection, other W thing, I don't know. It's like the main organization that Darius used to work for in the series. He's essentially revealed to be the big, big bad, even though he's not really. He's like one of the underlings that works for the bigger bad that will be revealed in later seasons. And he gets killed off by the Atrociraptors. I don't care for him either. But man, that's really all there is to talk about. Music was great. World building, fantastic. Soundtrack, cool. Just everything was great, man. And yeah, I believe that's all I can talk about, because there's not really that much in season one, because it's season one, obviously. We have to wait for more seasons. But yeah, man, Chaos Theory season one, 9 out of 10. Fantastic. It was great. Only reason it's not a 10 out of 10 is because there wasn't that much stuff to it, you know? There wasn't that much meat to the bone, you know? There's just like, you know, a little bit of thin layer of flesh and then, you know, some bone marrow that you can suck out of the bone. Horrible example, but you know what I mean. Essentially, there wasn't that much to it yet. Anyway, I say yet because there will be more coming up, and I am ready for that. I am 100% ready for that. My camera is angled sort of weird. I just noticed that. Wow. Okay. I'm not redoing this over, so you just gotta bear with it. Sorry, guys. But yeah, man, Camp Cretaceous was fantastic. Chaos Theory was fantastic. I love this series. It was great. It's a great sequel series. It's very promising. We're very looking forward to seeing where this goes next. I can't wait for later seasons. I can't wait to see how this cast grows, change. I can't wait to see what they do with Darius and Brooklyn. I can't wait to see what they do with, you know, Kenji and Darius, Kenji and Brooklyn, Sammy, Yasmina, Ben. You know, Ben apparently has a girlfriend. No one believes him. Neither do I. But hey, we'll see where that goes in season two, man. I can't wait for this series to continue. I hope you guys will be there for me when it does, and I'll be reviewing every season in this style of format when it comes out. And that's gonna be into this video, end of today's video. I can't fucking speak spaghetti mouth. Sorry again for the late uploads. Again, graduation, busy as hell. You know how it is. I got a lot of stuff going on. And that's gonna be into today's video. Hopefully, you guys enjoyed. If you did, leave a like, subscribe. Until next time, I'll see you all in the next video. Peace.